welcome to today's yin yoga class. So in today's class, the only items we may be using is a blanket for comfort with our knees. Keep a blanket handy in case you do need it, and a yoga strap, or even if you have one of those flexible exercise straps, it's okay. So you're going to definitely, or there's a possibility you're going to be needing a yoga strap, so have that handy. So today we're going to start some goddess breathing. So take your legs out as far as you comfortably take them. Bend your knees. Make sure your knees are above your ankles. You're going to take a deep breath in and out. Take a deep breath in. Swing your arms up above your head and breathe. And out. As you breathe out, bring your hands down. Straighten your legs. Breathe in, swing your arms, bend your knees, hands above your head, breathe out, hands down, stretching your legs. Breathe in, and out, breathe in, and out, and one more, breathe in, hold. And slowly breathe out. Bring your feet in, toes pointing forward so that your feet are hip width apart. Roll your shoulders back. Stand tall and strong on the mat from the bottoms of your feet up to the top of your head. Feel a nice long extension happening. Bring your hands up in front of your heart and pray. And we're just going to hold this pose here for around a minute. Nice deep breath in, and on the out breath, raise your hands up above your head, bring your hands apart, but keep the palms facing each other, and then push your bum backwards into a seated pose, bend those knees, and we're just going to sit here in a seated pose, a standing seated pose for around a minute, and a nice deep breath in and out through your nose. More comfortable for you, you can fold forward slightly. Try to keep your back as straight as possible. Deep breath in. On the out breath, slowly lower your hands down to the mat. Bend your knees as much as you need to be able to comfortably have your hands flat on the mat. Knit your neck and head dangle. Grab a hold of your elbows into dangling pose. If you want a deeper stretch, swing your arms around the back of your neck and grab a hold of your wrists. If this becomes too much, you can just rest your elbows on top of your knees And we're going to be in this state for about 2 minutes. Last deep breath in. On the out breath, lower your hands to the mat. Take your feet out about 9 feet apart. Point your toes out slightly out at about a 45 degree angle, and come down into a squat. Adjusting your feet as you need to be able to keep them flat on the mat. Place your elbows on the inside of your knees. Push your knees open into and create prayer pose. Your hands in front of your chest. If this is too difficult for you, you can sit on your block or your bolster while you do the squat and find the pose that's most comfortable for you. It's perfect. I'm going to hold you for around 2 minutes. please drop your hands to the mat. Lift your bum up. I want you to drop your left knee down to the mat and place your hip. Make your foot nice and flat on the mat behind you. Take your right foot out to the side. Try to bring your foot flat onto the mat, toes pointing forward. Roll your spine up. Take your right hand, the back of your right hand, slide along your right leg. Left hand up and over your head. I'm just going to rest here for a few minutes. Give a nice deep breaths. In and out through your nose. Okay, nice deep breath in. On the out breath, lower your arms, fold forward, bring your hands to the mat, bring your right knee in onto the mat, foot flat behind you, lift leg up to the side, foot flat on the mat, toes pointing forward, roll yourself upwards. Nice deep breath in. On the out breath, palm the back of your left leg, your left hand, sorry, slide it down your left leg. So the right arm up over your head. Nice deep breath in. Fold forward or sideways. Breathe out. Nice deep breaths here. You're feeling a really good stretch in the inner thigh and along the side of your body. Nice deep breath in. On your out breath, bring your arms down and to the mat. And what I want you to do is walk your hands to the front of your mat. Tuck those back toes in, swivel on your foot. Bring your right leg to the back. And then bring yourself into a plank pose. You're going to just hold this plank for around a minute. If you struggle with full plank, you can go down on your knees and do a semi plank. Now to a side plank, nice deep breath in. On the out breath, rotate your feet out onto the side, lift up your left hand up to the roof, look up, support yourself with your right hand. If you are doing a plank on your knees, then just roll the lower end of your feet out and then lift your left hand up to the ceiling. Whichever is most comfortable. Breathe in. On the out breath, lower your left hand to the mat. Roll your feet in the opposite direction. Lift your right arm up to the sky. Look up to the ceiling. And nice deep breath in. On the out breath, bring that hand down to the mat and push yourself back into downward facing dog. You need to push from the palms of your hands and gently stretch out the backs of those legs. Deep breath in. On the out breath, bring that right knee down to the mat. Bring your left foot as far forward as you can. Stretch and lengthen that right leg as you bring your knee to above your ankle in the front to lift. Place both hands on the inside of your left foot into dragon pose and look up. Remember, there should be no discomfort in your back knee. If there is, place a blanket underneath it, or if you need to, adjust your knees so it's as comfortable as possible. You must look after those knees. Breathe in. On the out breath, place all your weight on your right hand. Take your left hand, push the inside of your left knee, roll your left foot carefully onto its side. And you're going to go into twisted dragon, so gently push that knee out and look up to the ceiling over your left shoulder. on the out breath, lower that left hand to the mat. Bring your left foot behind you and push yourself back up into downward facing dog. Nice deep breath in. On the out breath, lower that left knee to the mat. Bring your right foot as far forward as you can. Lengthen that back leg as you bring your right knee over and above your right ankle. Both hands on the inside of your right foot and look up a dragon. Make sure you be mindful of that back knee and use padding or blanket if you need to. And nice deep breath in. On the out breath, take your weight onto your left hand. Use your right hand to gently push out your right knee, roll your right foot onto the side, and look up at the ceiling over your right shoulder into twisted dragon. Deep breath in. On the out breath, with both hands to the mat. Swing your right leg behind you, lift up into downward dog. Remove any blankets you may be using. Lower both your knees to the mat, going into wide leg child's pose, so big toes touching. Knees mat width apart. Push yourself back to sit on your mat. Walk your hands forward and come to rest your body on the mat in front of you. Take a nice deep breath in. On the out breath, lift your forehead. Walk your hands over to the right, which creates a nice C curve in your spine. And lower your forehead back down to the mat.
Or as you can comfortably go, bending to the right, not moving anywhere from the waist down. Nice deep breath in. And now bend your forehead. Walk your hands over to the left. Create a nice C curve with your body. And go as comfortably as you can while being able to lower your forehead back down to the left. Nice deep breath in. Collaborate with your forehead, come back to center. Stretch your arms out as far as you can on the mat and lower your forehead down to the mat. Deep breath in. And that breath, lift your head, walk yourself forward onto your mat. Then I want you to come up onto your hands. I want you just to curve your body forward, bring your knees flat onto the mat, your feet flat onto the mat, and lift yourself up into seal. Remember not to lock your elbows, rather twist your elbows inwards, and you're bending up from the thighs and not the hips. Feeling a really good stretch in your abs. Now if you can, I want you to bend your knees and point your toes and try and tip your head towards your feet. A nice deep breath in. On the out breath, push yourself back. Bring your feet and knees together on the mat into a closed leg child's pose. So bring your head down to the mat, stretch your forehead on the mat, hands at your side, palms facing up, and drop those shoulders, release any tension in those neck and shoulders. Nice deep breath in. And now we're going to use your hands to push yourself up. Swing your legs out to the side and in front of you. Take your right leg out as far as you can comfortably go. Bring your left foot onto the inside of your right leg. Turn to face your right leg. Take your right hand out to the right corner, far corner of your mat. Take your left hand, pointy ballet fingers, up and over your head. Breathe, nice deep breaths. Your mind begins to wander, bring back to your breath. Nice deep breath in. And then breath on your hands to mat. Swap your feet around. Extend your left leg out as far as you can comfortably go. Sorry about that. Right foot in on the inside of your left leg. Turn your body to face your left foot. Take your left hand out to the corner of your mat. Right hand up and over your head, pointing those ballet.
last deep breath in. On the out breath, bring your hands down to the mat. Bring your feet both flat on the mat and in space. Make sure that you are as centered to your mat as you need to be. And make sure you have your yoga strap ready. You're going to be using those. We might be using those soon. So I want you to put your hands out in front of you. Deep breath in. On the out breath, slowly roll yourself back onto the mat and roll over onto the side. I want you to roll comfortably onto your left shoulder so that your ear can be flat on the mat here. Now I want you to bring your right leg out as straight as you can. If you can grab a hold of your right leg and bring it out, then do so. If you can't, grab your strap, wrap it around your foot, and bring it out and hold onto the strap with your left hand. Then I want you to bend your left knee and grab a hold of your right ankle. If you can't do that and you need a strap, then rather just rest your right leg in front of you. Put the strap around your left foot and hold that there with your right hand, and then just extend your left hand in front of you. So try the variations of these which is the most comfortable for you to do. And you can look up to the roof once you have found your spot. On the upper side, release your left foot, and then your right, and your back. Fall over onto your right side now. Bring your left foot out. Grab it if you can. And bend your right knee and grab your right ankle to your left hand. Take a moment to find which pose is the most comfortable for you and see if you need to use your strap. When you have your position, look up to the ceiling. Breath in. On that breath, release your right foot and then your left. Bring it back to mat, fall onto your back, hug your knees into your chest. And release. Drop your feet to the mat, lift your feet forward quite naturally. Hands at your side, palms facing up, shoulders away from the ears, into Shavasana, final resting pose. We're going to reset just for a minute or two and let our bodies recuperate from all the work we've just done. we would absorb all that work so that we can become stronger and more flexible. And bring your attention back to the room. Take a nice deep breath in and out through your mouth. Wiggle your fingers and toes, move your head from side to side. When you're ready, roll over onto your side, push yourself up into a seated position. And one last deep breath in and out. Of your heart. Thank you for joining me here today. Go well. Namaste.